You doing?
Record. Hi, my name's Mrs. Colson. I will be your science teacher, and you guys will be seeing me first thing every day. Lucky you.
Hey guys, I'm Mr. Bright. I'll be your seventh grade math teacher this year.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Yuntis. I am your seventh grade English language arts teacher. Welcome to the Liberty team.
Hello, I'm Mr. Sylvester. I am your seventh grade social studies teacher. I'll be seeing you every day. Last period of the day.
Yeah. Right. So the first thing we want to do, guys, we want to share what your schedule is going to look like as virtual learners in the Liberty hallway. So let me, here we go. Okay, so the first thing you guys will do is you will log into Mrs. Colson's class. Mrs. Colson is the science teacher. She's the one who just introduced herself first. You'll have her class from 7:30 to 8:15 in the morning. Make sure you guys are logging on at 7:30. We've been instructed to count you guys tardy if you're late. We've been instructed to count you absent if you do not log on to the class. So make sure you guys are doing that. And then you're gonna have me for math second period from 8:20 to 9:05. You're gonna have Mrs. Yentes for core three. Now that's all the way in the afternoon, so there's gonna be a little bit of a break here. You'll have Mrs. Yentes from 12:20 to 1:05, and then you'll log in to Mr. Sylvester's class. There's about a 10-minute gap, so you guys can use the restroom. There's only a 5-minute gap between your first and second period classes, but there's a 10-minute gap in the afternoon. The reason for that is because we're gonna have students in our classrooms also, and that gives them time to clean off desks for the kids that are at school. And so you'll have Mr. Sylvester from 1:15 to 2 o'clock. So 45-minute classes, just like a normal school year. What we would encourage you guys to do is between your math and language arts classes, your encore teachers, whatever encore class you guys have, and it's going to be different for each one of you, they're going to be e-learning classes. And so what that means is they're not live. You'll get videos pushed out to you like you did last year at the end of the year from your encore teacher. That could be PE, health, band, choir, art, busset, whatever that class is. You'll have two of those. And so we would encourage you to get that work done in the middle. Also, you can eat lunch somewhere in that time. And then once your social studies class is over at 2 o'clock, you have the rest of the day to get whatever homework done that you need to do. So this is gonna be your guys' virtual schedule for at least this first semester. And if we have to change things as we go, obviously we'll be in contact with you guys every day. So let us know if you have any questions over this schedule. And I'll let Mrs. Yentes chime in. She's got some expectations now for the virtual learners.
Just some suggestions. Really, for how to make this successful. One of the things is to designate an area in the house or apartment that is like the classroom that you're going to use to do all of your virtual work and your e-learning work in. That just sets the tone that when you're in that room, that's where you're working. And then when you leave, you kind of have the rest of the house to work in. And maybe it's a room that's not very distracting that you can get work done. The other thing is you should be using your school iPad for your schoolwork, not any personal devices. Just don't intermix the two. Schoolwork is on your school iPad, personal devices are something else. All four of us will go over our classroom expectations with you guys on the first day of school. So you'll get those on the first day of school like the students do that are in class. And the last thing is we're here to help you guys academically and socially. So you can always reach out to us if you ever need anything.
All right, guys. Well, we look forward to seeing you guys in class with us on Wednesday morning and Wednesday afternoon for your language arts and social studies classes. So if you have any questions, feel free to email us those questions. I'm going to attach those emails in the Google form that we're sending out with this video. So you guys have our contact information and you can reach out with any questions that you and your parents might have before the first day of school. So we look forward to seeing you guys and have a great weekend, and we'll see you soon.